Hello everyone. So we are here solving question number 5 to 10 of assignment 3. We are given with a laser cavity with cavity length D. The R1, R2, the reflectivities are given to us. We know the refractive index N of the medium inside. The internal cavity loss of the system is given. We know the central wavelength. Let us represent it as lambda naught. The optical confinement factor is known and the gain coefficient is known. And we are also having the information that the groove velocity here is equal to the phase velocity. So let us start with part A of the question. We need to find the mode number corresponding to the central wavelength or lambda naught of the cavity. So we know that in a laser medium, the modes are separated by FSR frequency. So, any supported frequency is going to be an integer multiple of FSR. Now, we know that if we simplify this expression, we know that F is C by lambda is equal to M into C by 2nd. Now, if we cancel out the C, lambda or lambda naught here, the central wavelength will be equal to 2nd divided by, let us represent the central mode number as M naught, 2nd by M naught. Now, M naught equal to 2nd divided by lambda naught. So we have all the information given to us here. So we need to just substitute. Part B of the question needs us to calculate, it's a straightforward question, separation between two consecutive modes. So we know that separation between two consecutive supported modes is nothing but our FSR. And we just now wrote the expression, FSR is nothing but C by 2nd, and we have all the information here. We need to substitute this. Moving on to part C of the question. So we need to find the threshold gain in case of part C. So we know that for sustained modes, we need to have the gain equal to the loss of the cavity, which is the total loss alpha of the cavity, and it will be a summation of two components. One is the alpha cavity, the internal cavity loss, and then the mirror loss, the loss that is contributed by the end mirrors. Now alpha cavity is given to us. We know that alpha cavity is 0.05 meter inverse. What we do not are not given is the alpha mirror. So, alpha mirror we need to find. The expression, as we know, is 1 by 4d ln of 1 by r1 into r2. So, we know the cavity length d, r1 and r2, which we need to find the alpha mirror and then add it with alpha cavity. That will give us the threshold gain. Now part D. Part D of the question is to find out the line width of the laser. And we are given that it is an SLM, a single longitudinal mode laser. In that case, the delta nu or the line width or FWHM of the laser is given by the ratio of FSR to the thinness of the cavity. Now, the FSR of the cavity we already calculated in part B of the question. So, that is known to us now. Now, the thinness is equal to pi root r divided by 1 minus r. Now, we are making an assumption here. The assumption is that the line width is going to be a function of only the cavity parameters and it is independent of the gain medium. Independent of the gain medium. In that case, R will be equal to square root of R1, R2. We know that R1 and R2 are actually reflectivities, intensity ratios, into e to the power minus 2 alpha d. So again, we have all the information to calculate the R, small r, which we will substitute to find fineness. And together, FSR and fineness will give us the delta nu. Now let's move to part E to find the photon lifetime, tau p of the cat. Tau p equal to photon lifetime. Let us revisit how we calculate. So we have a medium where we have p naught photon number at the beginning of the cavity, and we need to find p naught by e whenever it reduces to the time required to become p naught by e is what we want to calculate. So we know that p equal to the photon number equal to p naught into e to the power minus 2 alpha into z. Z is the length of the medium. So we know that the reason we are putting 2 alpha here is because alpha is the loss coefficient for field. So we need to multiply it by 2 when it is about photon or intensity or power. So alpha is loss coefficient for field. So for this condition to be true, what to be equal to 1 by 2 alpha for it to be p naught by e at the end of the medium. So which means that we know that time is the ratio of distance divided by velocity, which means z, we substitute it by 1 by 2 alpha divided by the velocity, the group velocity, which is equal to phase velocity. So substituting 1 by 2 alpha pg. So that means the alpha we know is the combination of alpha cavity plus alpha mirror multiplied with Vg with a factor of 2. That will give us the photon lifetime. Now let us move to the last question, which shares the common information, part F. We have uncoated facets here, which means that the R1 and R2 value we will actually come down compared to what it was, 1 and 0.9. And it is given to us that it is 0.32. So we need to again calculate the threshold gain, which is equal to alpha cavity plus 1 by 4d into ln of 1 by R1 into R2. So we need to substitute again all the new value of R1 and R2 and find the gain threshold. And this solves all the question number 5 to 10. I have used A to F the notation here, but they represent question 5 to 10 of the assignment, which shares the same common information.